Scrolls of the Megalos. Scrolls of the Megalos. Oh!
best song that we've got here is the title track of the demo. In fact, the tune we played before, Brutal Warfare, is going to be off the forthcoming album. And we're, you know, we're going to probably re-record the demo, but with a lot better time. We did that demo in 10 hours, so, well, two up to 10 hours, but it's really good. And we're going to re-record it eventually, and it's going to be a lot heavier. We should have a CD out in about 4 months, but in the meantime, the demo's available on the table for $10. 6-track sneak preview of the new album. Look out of print once we release it. Break the Curse is the title track of this song, and we did this in the old Life Force when I was in it about 3 years ago. And we thought we'd resurrect it because the mosh pit's going to love this song. Hope you're ready! Break the Curse is basically about the fact that we have choices, and you know, we can choose. If you have a bad situation in your life, and bad circumstances, you can change it through putting your trust on Jesus Christ. And I've been through some bad situations. Anyone that knows me knows that I've been through some bad situations. But everyone is, you know, if you're down or if life's tough, and it can be, you know, you can choose by you know, putting your trust and all your problems on Jesus to turn your life around and have a ball. It's not always easy, but, you know, life can be a lot better. That's the truth. I know you don't have to stay there. That's the message of it. Break the curse that's in your life. You know, choose to break the curse. The devil has no favorites. This is break the curse.
I'm not. I want your mind, find your belly. want to hear into a bit of death metal grindcore or what? This is a song off our second album, and often in life, I'm sure most of you people out there have been to a funeral, and it's very interesting what people say at funerals. Often they say very heavenly things, but in reality, the person that has just died is probably standing before the judgment seat, and they're probably on their way to hell. It's really sad when that happens at a funeral. We had a friend of ours, a very close friend of ours, who was a Christian, but he went away from the Lord, and he got involved in a whole lot of drugs and things like that, and he ended up committing suicide. And we at this day don't know where he is. We hope God had mercy on him. This next song talks about dying and about the fact that it doesn't matter what people say at a funeral, if you don't know Christ, you're going to hell. That's fact! Death Requiem!
Thank you. Yeah. Here is the vocalist and the bass player of the band. And perhaps he may have a comment. What did he think of the gig?
On
national TV in the toilet.
Play drums for Mortification. We've been in Mortification for about a year now. Everything's going pretty good. Before I was in the band, I was with Brody with the band for about 4 years or so. For the last drummer left to Phil, and the last guitarist Michael left with myself and Lincoln. We've just recently joined the band last year, so we're one of the new boys in the band, but we're here to stay this time. We really are committed to the whole band and the ministry of the band. It's not going to be more Mortification as long as it goes.
Hey, it's Steve here from Mortification. It's good to be here in Christchurch, and we played at the arena tonight, which was really good. I heard a few people about the Lord, which was cool. And got filmed by a few different people, so hopefully we'll get a few copies out. And it's really good to travel all over the world and tell people about Jesus, hey. That's the most important thing, you know, to give a positive message and hopefully see a few people turn around for a better way of life. A lot of people are looking for answers in the wrong places, but we go and tell them, you know, through metal about Jesus, and we play metal full on, but we tell them about the Christian message, which has really seen heaps of changes in people. We see the response in the pub tonight. A few people hassle me, but I think that, you know, the message got through pretty strong and people really enjoyed it. So it's good to come out here to New Zealand and play a few shows. And cheers to all New Zealand fans, mate. Boys.
Thank you. mutters, "Die for your faith!" I'm gonna go get some more.
you're watching The Heavy Shift. I'm Jess and I'm here with two members of Modification. I'm here with Steve and Adam. They have sold, they're a Melbourne metal band, and they have sold over 250,000 records worldwide, which is no mean feat for an Aussie band. Welcome to the show, you guys.
Thank you.
Good to be here. Good to be at Metal Warriors 2001.
Yeah, it's good to be playing with a lot of local bands and one band from Sydney. It's good to see metal on the rise again.
Excellent. Now, 250,000 albums later, we got any tours coming up?
Yes, well, we've just finished our 10th studio album, which is called The Silver Cord is Severed.
Which is, if I may, this is it here. It's available, it's through Modern Invasion?
Yeah, you can get it through Modern Invasion. Best to pick it up at your Utopias and Metal Mayhem's, place like that, but you should be able to get it at JB in Melbourne, that sort of thing. We have, since 93, we've toured America 5 times and Europe 3 times. We're about to go on our first world tour this year.
Wow.
Which we'll take in South Africa, 3 shows, 10 shows in Europe, taking us all the way from Switzerland, Germany, all the way up through to Scandinavia, 10 shows in the United States, and then Mexico City, Brazil and Argentina.
Now that's a world tour. That is a world tour. So, as well as this upcoming world tour, which will probably be, long and arduous, but I'm sure you'll have a hell of a good time.
Yep. With the old lineup, we've got a different lineup now. Adam here is our new young drummer that's been with us for a year, and that's an interesting story in itself, because I used to look after Adam when he was just a young kid.
Just a young thing running around, well, causing havoc.
There's 20 years difference between us, so I turned 36 today and he's 16, so it's interesting to have some youth in the band and some energy, and we're just getting into it and doing the best we can to represent Australian music around the world.
So let me ask you guys, why Christian metal?
Well, back in the early days when we started out basically as a death metal band, I think the lyrical content wasn't quite so extreme, but then with black metal coming back in 1994, I thought, well, why not be extra extreme about what we say, because it's so different. I mean, there's so much black metal out there now that it's just really overblown. The reason we changed our style of music a little bit as well was because the death metal scene became overblown. And religion, I think, is starting to become more and more accepted in heavy music. You see on the new Soulfly record, they have Psalm 91 on there, and there's bands like Shelter and some other bands bringing religious ideas. So I think people are becoming more and more open to different religious ideas, and this is what we believe, and so why not be extreme about it? I mean, everybody else is being extreme about something.
And hey, why not let everyone enjoy metal?
Yeah, that's
whoever
right.
Whoever they may be, you should all enjoy the glory that is metal.
And obviously, like a lot of our fan base around the world, and the fact that we do get to tour around the world, is because people want to hear what we're singing about. As much as your average punter comes in out of interest, and that's how you sell records, by doing something that's different, unique and extreme.
Excellent. Good point of view. Stay strong. Let me ask Adam a quick question. You're only 16, buddy. Not even old enough to purchase a BB. Now, tell me, you've got what, 20 years difference between you and Steve?
Yeah, I was 36 today.
36 today. Happy birthday from the Heavy Shift. Now, you're about to embark on a world tour and you're 16.
Yeah.
This is what most people dream of when they're air-guitaring in their room to, Man of Warren. Slayer and what have you. So what's going on? I know he's a drummer, but other kids are air guitar. Drummer's air guitar, it happens. People like to change instruments, but how's it been for you?
It's been pretty good. It's better than school.
Oh, I can imagine so.
Nah, it's been really good. It got me out of lots of trouble and stuff. Had to quit a few things, but it's been good.
Excellent. Well, now, in the fine tradition of the Heavy Shift, we're going to ask you to pick a clip. What have you picked for us tonight?
Well, being a huge Iron Maiden fan, I remember buying the first Iron Maiden record when it came out in the late 70s. So The Wicker Man by Iron Maiden, I think, would be my pick for the night for sure, because Steve Harris is a complete legend.
This is Black Sun. You want to hear a big hi! Sounds like there's about three people out there, alright? Yeah. Now this time, I want the team to come down here, alright? You ready? Hey! 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 Alright, hot. This next song's a bit of a fun one, so whoever remembers this thing called circle moshing, you know, when you sort of... This is a perfect song to do this to. I wouldn't have picked it, but because I love my drummer Adam so much, he likes this one, so just to make him happy and keep a smile on his face, I thought we'd do this one, and if he plays it right, I might even let him do a drum solo later. Yeah! We're on time, it's doing good. This is called Three of a Kind. We'll be right back.
got any fans of some of the Mortification's older songs? This is Future Warfare.
This song's a bit different for us. Well, actually, there's two songs really. It's an intro plus a song. And we've never played these live, so you're special people. You're the initiated few.
Fuck the word. what you're gonna do to see that you move. Open up the words to know of the lying. Light the truth, the dark of the night. When we are, yeah, when we are.
This next song,
así es que la canción que sigue,
is about the 12 men,
habla acerca de los 12 hombres,
who had the privilege of following Jesus around the earth.
La canción que sigue habla de los 12 hombres que siguieron a Jesús.
The 12 disciples who followed Jesus.
Los 12 discípulos que siguieron a Jesús.
And Jesus called some of them, and some of them were just fishermen.
Y Jesús les llamó a ellos que ahora iban a ser pescadores de hombres.
And Jesus has a call for all of us.
Y Jesús entonces hizo una gran pesca de todos nosotros.
It doesn't matter whether you're a doctor.
Y no importa si tú eres un doctor.
Or whether you're a fisherman.
O si tú eres solamente un pescador.
Or whether you're as low as playing heavy metal music.
Y aún también puedes tocar heavy metal.
So even God can use someone like me.
Y aún Dios puede usar a gente como yo.
Which means that God can use impossible things.
Así es que eso significa que para Dios no hay cosas imposibles.
Many of you know that I have survived leukemia.
Muchos de ustedes saben que yo he sobrevivido a la leucemia.
Which is cancer, of course.
Que es un cáncer, por supuesto.
And right now,
y ahora mismo,
my feet feel like concrete.
Y ahora mismo me siento muy bien, como un conquistador.
So you need to 12 men.
Esto se llama los 12 hombres.
Jesus called the fishermen, asked them to follow him, become fishers of men. 12 men followed him, 12 men followed him, 12 men followed him. Jesus calls the modern man, asks him to follow him, become fishers of men. 12 men followed him, 12 men followed him, 12 men followed him. Come on, Mexico! Yeah!
follow him. They won't ever be the same again. Open for him. Open for him. Open. Let me hear some noise. Let me hear some noise.
What's your favourite Christian metal band?
At the moment, a band called Divine Fire, which is the side project of Christian from Narnia. And I like Narnia as well a lot.
Nice.
So those two bands too, man.
Cool. Do you have any pets? And are they very metal?
I have a dog called Keisha, who is in human years 109. She's 15.
Nice.
And somehow she's been kept alive by all the good music I play every day.
Cool. Just like you have, I guess.
That's right.
Have you ever dressed her up?
I've been kept alive by metal. And wood.
Yes. Nice. What's Mortification been up to lately?
We've got a new album out called Erasing the Goblin, which got a German release. We are touring in Central Latin and South America in November with Narnia and Rob Rock and Exusia. Exusia are a Mexican black metal style band.
Cool.
So we're doing Mexico City, Guatemala City, Honduras, Sao Paulo, Brazil, Buenos Aires, Argentina, Bogota, Colombia, and Costa Rica.
Wow, sounds like fun.
Fun, yeah.
How old are you, Steve, if that's not a rude question?
I am 41 years old.
Dude, that's old.
I started playing Christian metal in 1984.
That's when I was 9. Yep.
Long time ago.
Yeah. Have you ever considered giving up your dream of being, change it to a grind planet? Have you ever considered giving up your dream of being a grind planet? A rock star.
My dream of being a grind planet. Oh, yeah, an anti-rock star. When I got leukemia 10 years ago, I laid everything down and thought, yeah, maybe that was the end, and they got picked up again, and a couple of points I've considered it. But I get a lot of letters and emails from people from all over the world saying that you know, there's not a lot of events to live for. They know in the next 18 months to 2 years or whatever, there's going to be another modification album, and it means a lot to people worldwide. The history of the band, what we have to say, so that kind of inspires me to keep going.
And cool.
At the moment I'm helping out a mother in Queens in New York, which is a very poor part of New York, and she's got a daughter who is into death metal, and she didn't realise that it was Christian death metal, and she found my site, and so the mother feels like she's destroyed her daughter's life, because her daughter's 15 and wants to play guitar and has written all this artistic music and everything, and so I'm involved with the mum in trying to help this girl realise that God has given her a gift. Apparently she's a great guitar player.
Cool.
So it seems like that will inspire you to keep going.
That's awesome. Alright, what's the best gig you've ever been to?
Been to or played at?
Been to.
Wow.
Well, the best band.
Best
live.
Best band we've ever seen live. Tourniquet live is pretty awesome. I played with played with Tourniquet in 93 at Cornerstone, and I saw them on main stage at Cornerstone in 94. That was pretty awesome.
Cool. All right. What musician inspired you the most when you were first starting out as a musician?
Lemmy from Motorhead.
Cool.
Yeah, when I heard Ace of Spades, I thought, I think I'll have to do that.
Nice. Have you ever heard of my band, 3x5?
Yeah, I've heard of 3x5. I went and saw you play about 2 months ago.
We were awesome.
Go out and buy a 3x5 CD.
There aren't any here.
Rebrand, unfortunately.
What's the first metal album you ever bought?
Well, back in 1973, my older brother, brought home Deep Purple Machine Head. And Status Quo Pile Driver. And Susie Quattro Can the Can. And Slave Alive. So I listened to all that.
That's old.
And then when I was about 14, 15, I started listening to Motorhead and Iron Maiden. And then, of course, in 84, I heard Christian metal. I heard Resurrection Band. And it was just stepping stone for the rest of my life.
Awesome. That's cool. What's your favourite gig you've ever played?
We played at the Full Force Festival in 94. This guy was there.
That was fun.
This guy was the drummer of Mortification for one album. And besides the fact that we're using other people's gear, we had a couple of technical difficulties. It was actually a pretty amazing gig. There was a lot of people there, and Phil was on the stage with me. Did anyone know that Phil was in Mortification for an album? And after about the first song, you played the rest of the gig on gaffer tape. That's correct.
Yeah, the drum kit started falling apart.
Who's playing on?
We never found out whose drum kit it was either, and we broke it pretty badly.
Gaffer tape drum kit.
Yeah.
No, that was a pretty awesome gig.
That was cool.
And that's a highlight. Seeing that, talking to you.
Oh yeah.
That was a good tour too.
Yeah, it was nice. I enjoyed it. Cool. Alright, thanks Steve.
No worries.
Give Steve a round of applause. Thank you very much.
Metal. Off our last album, Raising the Golden, it's this. It's called The Dead Shall Be Judged. We'll be right back.
Anyway, we're gonna try a new one on you, okay? We're gonna be recording a new album starting very soon. And this one is called A Sense of Eternity.
The way of the beast, bringing forth a form of new life to come. Life is a vapor, hold on to the truthful way. Come on, black soul! Growing years in the sea, a sense of eternity. God within a man's desire. A sense of eternity struggling with me. I'm the divine within the power of God. I stand shaking the newborn reality. Integrity, strong man of God. The street who stand for the Lord cannot be. Captures all with integrity. The reborn arise to get up forever. Never to die, die. The way of the bomb, you thought way back to your heart. The ego, the strength of bomb, but with yourself I can take. Break her just like a vapor, hold her to the truthful way. That's it, come on! Let me see those hands here, come on! Fish everywhere! Breaking straight the way of old. Holy truth. Dead bone, God within a man's desire. A sense of eternity, life is a fate, but today is a day. Hold on to the reborn life unchanging. Only as strong as this point of recency. And the fight to remain presented from the hospital of the faith. No one can control the mission of God.
We are over time. We've got one little short one. Mr. Mick Jelinek on guitar. Mr. Dave Kilgallen, second gig on drums. This is a very, very short one. Just goes for 1 minute. This is Thanks for Having Us. We'll be up the back there in about half an hour's time to sign some DVDs and CDs. We've got to get off. This one's called God Rules. Have a good weekend. Thank you, Black Shop. Good night.